you're thinking of. Angela?
I think it's called Every Time.
Every Time? And Kelly?
There's a Stirring.
There's a Stirring? Okay, and Hoka?
Blessed Be Your Name.
Blessed Be Your Name? Okay. All right. Mom?
The Lord bless you and keep you.
The Lord bless you and keep you. Okay. Evangeline?
Confidence.
Confidence. Okay. That, I'm not sure we're going to have time to get to all of those, but I'm going to stop the request train there. Song leaders, if you haven't picked out a song yet, those are some great ones. And once we go through the songs, if you have picked one and you're ready for it, go with the one you're comfortable with. But we'll try to get to these ones after we get through the song leaders. So if you are a song leader and you heard one there that you wanted to lead, we'll get to that. For tonight, if you're leading, I'd like you to get up here, tell us all what key it's in, what note you're going to blow, and then if you're comfortable, point out where the mi, so, or do that the sopranos, altos, tenors, and basses are going to start on, and tell us the beat you're going to do. Is it 2-2, 3-4, or 4-4? So if you forget, don't worry. I don't want you to feel uncomfortable or too much pressure, but just want to reinforce the things we've been studying this weekend, and but also lift our voices to God. I don't want to forget the main point of why we're here, is to praise God and edify each other. Well, James is going to start us off. Are you ready?
I'm going to lead to Canaan's land. I'm on my way. This is in the key of F. And I'm going to start on the do. And it is in 4-4 time. But it starts on the fourth beat. So I'm going to go like this on two, and then Canaan's land. Okay. The altos start on the so. The basses and the sopranos start on do. And the tenors start on me. As we talked about the first time, everyone sit up straight. Remember, we're going to try to sing from our gut, from our diaphragm, from our abs, from down low. Not up here, but down low.
To Canaan's land, I'm on my way.
No friends, no family, no tears, no tears.
Yeah, do you know? Okay. I didn't write down who's in what order, so when you see your song, like this one is Rodney, just come on.
Once we're done with the guys who have given James a song, then we'll open it up to anybody else that wants to lead.
So this song was requested, and I've never done this song, but it's a good thing for me to practice this song because all of the songs I do are not that hard for me. But this is a good song for me to start out. So it's in 4/4 beat, E flat, B flat, which I normally blow both, and it starts off with a do, correct?
No.
No. See, that's why I'm learning.
It is, yeah. It is E flat, so you're gonna blow an E flat, and everybody starts on so.
Okay, so.
So everybody, so the altos and sopranos and tenors are all gonna go down to so, and then the basses have to go down another octave to so.
So, so me.
No. Do so.
Oh. Do so.
Yes.
Oh, do so. Oh, that's right. That's
yep. Flat. But wait, there's more. This one, we talked last night a little bit about how the beat is kind of the feel of the song. This song has no feeling. The beat you're beating is very difficult. And it doesn't match up exactly what you would think it would be. But remember what we talked about. He's going to be going for a downbeat right after we pass one of those measure bars. So if you get lost on the beat, you're going down after that. But it also, I don't think it starts on the downbeat.
No. It doesn't start on the downbeat.
What?
Because normally I'm doing a song.
I think the rest downbeat. Is the downbeat. But
the rest. Okay, so the rest is the downbeat. So, yeah. And that's... a 16th with a dot, which is nobody's gonna know how to beat that with your hand. So basically, as his beat is coming down, you're going, you call me out upon. No, that wasn't right, was it?
Yeah. That's right, like the second beat.
Yeah. You call me out upon. So you is kind of there, and call is at the second beat. So you get a little lost with the rest at the beginning there. You're saying call at the second beat, if that helps. If not, Rodney's going to ace this, so just follow him.
Thank you for the encouragement. All right, let's try it. And if I don't ace this, I'll never do this.
So, no. Well, on this one, I want you to just, it will help you, but just blow the E flat because the B flat on there is actually going up.
Yeah.
And it's not the note anybody's actually singing. So.
Yeah, so.
So blow that again with E flat.
So, you call me out upon the waters, the great unknown, where feet may fail.
My faith will stand. I'll call your name.
beat that very well.
Thanks. Yeah. Yes. So a couple things on that one. If you're a new song leader, I don't recommend it because it's very difficult to lead. But you'll notice there's, we've talked about it a little bit this weekend. The song leader is almost always going to be singing the top row of notes, which is the soprano, which is the lead and the melody. But on that one, you have some options. I prefer when there's a part when just the ladies are singing to just let the ladies sing because I like to listen to that. So if you're a song leader, sometimes maybe you just start that part and then let the ladies go if it's a ladies-only part. But you can sing along too. Some congregations just don't really have a lot of ladies singing out, so you may need to sing that part. But you can also, in the chorus, you can switch to the bass if that's what you're more comfortable with, especially on a song that's really hard to lead. It might be easier for you to just go right to bass. So just some things to think about. You ready?
Yes.
All right.
And then.
It's low C, right?
Yes. So you're going to blow a C.
It's this one?
Yep, that's correct. Wait, I'll wait just a minute. So then you're going to go up to so. And we'll help you with that. The altos are going to be at mi, and the tenors are so, and the basses are at do. What are you going to beat?
Beat.
What's your hand going to do?
Go up and down.
Up and down. All right. And you're starting on the down beat.
Yeah.
All right. You got this.
Jesus loves me, this I know. For the Bible tells me so.
Verse or the first couple slides of a song, so that's technically his first time leading a full song, so
yeah.
Very impressive. And from all the old people, it warms our hearts to see you young people getting up here and stepping up, so thank you. Speaking of young people stepping up.
All right. There you
go. Go Dylan!
Okay, so what are you going to blow?
G.
A G, so that's the do. Wait, don't blow it yet. So the
G, so, and mi.
All right. Okay, well, wait. I know you want to get this over with. What beat are you going to do? The 4-4 one.
Yeah, 4.
Okay, so what beat are you starting on?
4.
Yep, you're starting on the fourth beat, which is up. So, oh, come is on the downbeat. Okay, now go
can
for
I
it.
Oh,
That was Dylan's first time using the full song too. And are you next? And I think this is your first time using the full song, right?
So it is, I do an F,
yep.
And I believe it is a 4-4.
Correct.
And we start on the E?
Me.
Me.
Yeah, so you're blowing an F and going up to me. Jump into the different parts, which is very difficult to do for a song leader. And one of the things that I really encourage you that he was doing is looking around. He wasn't just staring at the PowerPoint. He was looking around and he was projecting, and really easy to follow when you're doing that. So really good job.
Thank you.
Good luck following that, Isaiah.
So I think these PowerPoints are handy because we have a cheat. A lot of hymnals don't have the cheater up in the corner, and you have to just know what all that means over on the side. And I don't. So D flat is the key in which we're singing. The sopranos will be starting with. So, the alto will take me, tenor will also have so, and bass will start on the do. This is in 4-4 time signature.
starting on
the third beat.
The fourth.
Yes,
fourth beat.
The up yeah. Is the first beat. I can't find so on my own, so Ryan, can you help me find so?
Yeah, yeah. All right, thank you. Do that D flat again.
There is beyond the azure blue.
if you get the last slide, I want to make a comment. Go ahead then.
Well, you go first.
This young man took me back over 60 years in the way he directed. I want to tell you what he did that I really loved. Were you any doubt as to where his beat was?
No.
Why? It wasn't waving around and you had to guess where the beat was. When he came down, what did he do? Boom! He knew where the beat was. Boom, boom, boom. Now, I had a choral director when I, of course, as I sang it. He was blind. One of the best choral directors I have ever had. And his beat was totally for 60 or 70 choral voices. And we all knew exactly where it was. And this was his beat. That's all he did. So long as you establish the beat, we'll follow you. Now, one warning, Amos, especially for young directors, and that was my problem also, because I was afraid of directing and being the actual one to establish the beat. So I let the congregation establish my beat for me. So what I wind up doing is waiting and going down to make that beat when they did it. The problem with that is you'll get a song that was intended to be sung very cheerfully and upbeat, and a rhythm and a slowness that puts it to sleep, that puts us to sleep. So as a director, when you know what the beat is, you do it and let us come to you. Excuse me, sorry.
That's all right. A couple of things on that. One of the things we talked about just briefly is energy. And energy doesn't mean loud, it doesn't mean fast, it means energy. It means you're up here praising God. And that may be a slow song, but you can lead a slow song with energy. You can lead a fast song with energy. You can also drag almost any song down if you really want to. And the congregation, I don't know what this is about congregations, because I do it when I'm sitting out there too. We want to drag you down. A lot of times you have to fight against the congregation to keep that energy up, but that's your job up here. Keep the energy up. Now, some interesting points there. Isaiah had a very steady beat, and one of the things we talked about last night, specifically this song, at least in our congregation, we want to kind of drag it out at the end. So his beat fell apart at the end because he was trying to beat it correctly, and we were saying, no, that's not what we're doing. So one of the tricks we talked about, and this I do it on this one, and you can use this at the end, if you know your congregation wants to drag, or if you want to drag it out, instead of trying to beat it correctly, just beat each note. So, created man, he is our God, the great I am. You can do it like that if you need to slow it off. Trying to get people to slow down, especially on a 4-4 and still beat it, is really difficult. But if you just hit each note, it's very clear, like you were saying, if you're hitting them very clear, then the people know when to hit those notes if it's not the same beat as what you've done for the rest of the song. But then it's your job, as we've drug you out a little bit, to get back on the right beat at the verse and get it back going again. So just some things to remember on that.
So Hosanna, it's a 4-4 beat, and it does not start on 1, does it?
No.
So it's going to start on 4. So it's going to be coming up. That'll be G as the key, and I'll be blowing G also because the sopranos start on Do, and the altos start below Do.
On so.
And the bass are also on Do, and the tenors are on B. This is very scary. You should hug a song leader whenever you get it.
Is this your first time leading
a
song?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right.
Your boys beat you to it.
Oh,
This one, so I don't have to tell you where the sopranos and the altos and the mezzos start. We're going to start on Do, which is F. It's in the key of F, and it's in F. It's 3/4 time, and starts on the downbeat. One thing about this song is that when it transitions to the more traditional part, and just before that, men, you might want to soften just a little bit to let, when the ladies have the melody, let the ladies take the melody, okay?
The other thing on this one to remember is, we talked about this yesterday, these are dotted quarter notes. So you hold it a little longer than this one. And here, we rush through this one and sing it differently for some reason. So I'm encouraging you not to do that. This beat here is the exact same timing as that there. So you hold, with the dot, you hold this note just a little bit longer.
What he's saying is, over here, flowing so free for me.
Right on the beats.
And over here, it's, that's where the fountain is flowing so. So the dots, that's what the dots do, okay? Oh, Jesus, Jesus, keep me near to the precious cross. That's where the fountain is flowing so free for me. It's free to everyone who looks to the Lord. You can see that it's flowing from Mount Calvary. Jesus, Jesus, keep me near to the precious cross. That's where the fountain is flowing so free for me. It's free to everyone who looks to the Lord. You can see that it's flowing from Mount Calvary.
And rest.
I shall find it with Jesus on the far river side. Till my raptured soul shall find, I shall find it with Jesus on the far river side.
That was another example there. At the end, he kind of drug it out, but he hit each beat so you knew what he was doing, and he was projecting so you could follow him. So you can do that at the end, and a lot of songs like this one, it gives us a little more power and feeling if you slow it down just a little bit, but you've got to be in control of that.
We're on to the question.
Okay. Did anybody that wanted to lead not get a chance to lead? What song do you want to lead?
970, I'm going to view that holy city.
I'm going to view that holy city. Come on up. What's your name?
Mike Wise.
What congregation are you from?
Canyon View.
All right.
So this is one that I've not led successfully before.
Tonight's the night.
So I'm looking for your feedback, please. How many are familiar with this song? Okay, good. So if you're not, just know that at the last stanza, with each verse, we repeat all the verses above it. So when we go, the first time we'll sing it, "View That Holy City," and then the next time we sing, "View That Holy City," and then "Meet My Loving Jesus," and then the third time, "View That Holy City, Meet My Loving Jesus," you know.
I think the PowerPoint does that.
That's true, yeah. So I think it's in the book. You have to explain it better.
Yeah, I think it'll be easy to follow there.
So it's a 4-4 time. Yep. It starts halfway through the measure.
It's a little weird. It starts on the downbeat, but then you've got two full beats of nothing, which for a song leader seems like 10 minutes of nothing when you're up here. So it's going to be, "I'm gonna view." So you're two full beats of rest there.
Okay. It's in the key of G, and the sopranos are going to have soul. Same with it looks like the tenors.
Tenors and bass are both on do.
Yeah.
Yep.
I'm gonna view that holy city. Oh, I'm gonna view.
Let's start that. Make sure to leave the two beats of nothing in there. So go ahead and blow it first. Let's start over. But yeah, you kind of holding that out a little bit there. But just beat through the silence. And
no, so I'm gonna view that holy city. Sit at the banquet table.
that holy city one of these days. I'm gonna feast on milk and honey. Oh, I'm gonna feast on milk and honey one of these days. I'm gonna feast on milk and honey. I'm gonna feast on milk and honey. Sit at the banquet table, meet my loving Jesus. View that holy city one of these days. I'm gonna sing and never get tired. Oh, I'm gonna sing and never get tired one of these days. Oh, I'm gonna sing and never get tired. I'm gonna sing and never get tired. Feast on milk and honey. Sit at the banquet table. Meet my loving Jesus. Hear that holy city one of these days.
All right. One thing I want to point out that you did that I really encourage you guys to do is when you blow the note, he actually said do. And sometimes you'll hear the song leader up here hum the note and you're not sure, is that the key or has he gone up to the starting note? If you say do, that helps everybody know that's the key. And then if you go do, mi, so, then they know you're going up there. So that's the other thing we talked about very briefly last night that I wanted to point out. There are a lot of bird's eyes in this song. And that's those bird's eye looking things. and we talked about that. What that means is you're holding that. The writer of the song has said, I want you to go a little off the beat on that one and hold that note a little longer. So as a song leader, you're just stopping your hand at that point for as long as you think is the right amount to hold that note. So that's what those mean. The other thing we talked about too is math and reducing. And part of the reason we reduce is because I've never led this song, so I should have said this at the beginning. But you're actually going, I'm gonna view that holy. That's the correct way to beat it. You look like a lunatic up here doing that. And you get really tired. So what you did is you kind of reduced it to a more reasonable beat, but you can still follow the beat. The other thing you can do is just go up and down on one like that and hit the beat. And on this one, it's a little easier to do that because they've got some weird timing in there that's hard to follow, and you're doing bird's eye, so you can just stop, sit at the banquet table, meet my loving Jesus. Now, don't follow me on that. You get the point, Dad.
What this one doesn't put the time signature change in there, but you're going from 4-4 to 2-4, 4-4 to 2-4, and that's...
Remember when we talked about 4-4, how many beats per measure?
Four.
Well, there's not four in there.
There's only two.
And 4-4, so which note gets the beat?
Quarter
notes. So in this measure, how many quarter notes are there?
Two.
Usually, there'll be a 2-4 here to tell you that that's switched. So you picked a really difficult song to beat, but you did.
But it's another good reason to beat that one up and down.
Yeah, because you're having to switch so much back and forth in this that it makes it a lot easier.
Yeah. All right. You'll notice it also does it up there on the table. There's only two quarter notes with the bird's eye. And anyone want to take a guess at exactly how long we usually hold that bird's eye? Is enough to make four beats, because that's what feels right to us. That's what the rest of the song has been doing. But here, you're on your own. Do what you want.
That was my struggle when I was practicing that I had.
Yeah. Well, you picked a very difficult one to beat. And really, the correct way to beat it is to beat it really fast and switch to 2-2 and really fast and switch it to 2. Correct on paper. The right way to do it is to just go up and down with the beat, and then you're not having to switch your beat between things, and it's easier to hold the bird's eyes when you want. And that song, it's an old spiritual song, so it's got a lot of feeling, and being able to help the congregation stop and hold those notes and really get the feeling out of it is a lot easier when you're just going up and down. Tyler, you're gonna lead?
Yeah, he's got my song.
Okay, well, while we're doing that, I'm gonna take a wild guess. Ryder, you had your hand up a second ago. What song were you gonna request? Was it Roll the Gospel Chariot Along? If you're not a member here, that's Ryder's favorite song. So while he's picking that up, I have no advice for leading kids' songs except do it so that I don't have to. I've been doing it for a long time, and a lot of the same things apply. You want to have energy, and it's easy to have energy because you get to see the smiles of the kids coming back at you. But if you're nervous, it's good practice because you have to put any fear of looking silly, you have to just put it aside to lead kids songs. So let's sing, I think most of us know this one. So let's sing Roll the Gospel Chariot Along.
Roll the gospel chariot along. Roll the gospel chariot along. Roll the gospel chariot along. And we won't tag along behind. If our brother's in the road, we will stop and pick him up. If our brother's in the road, we will stop and pick him up. If our brother's in the road, we will stop and pick him up. And we won't tag along behind. If our sister's in the road, we will stop and pick her up. If our sister's in the road, we will stop and pick her up. If our sister's in the road, we will stop and pick her up. And we won't tag along behind. If the devil's in the road, we will run right over him. If the devil's in the road, we will run right over him. If the devil's in the road, we will run right over him. And we won't tag along behind.
All right, you ready for Tyler's? What's your time?
Mansion Road with the Crown. F is the do. And then altos are on so. Bass and sopranos are on do, tenors are on mi. 4/4 starts on.
It's barely the upbeat. Yep.
3.5.
Yeah.
So do. No, just kidding.
Okay, start over here.
I'm gonna trade my earthly home for a better one, bright and fair. Christ likes to bear a mansion for his children in the air. I'll join him in that land where tears nor sorrows can be found. There I now receive my mansion, mansion roll and crown. Lord, I want to set the mansion. The crown in glory, may I know that peace and love will always abound forever. Let me be young, for the city your throne surround. Lord, please reserve my mansion, mansion roll and crown. The weather there is always fair, there's sunshine day and night. No cold and rain will fall there, where the sun shines ever bright. I'll be no heavy garments, I'll just wrap my robe around. When I receive my mansion, mansion robe and crown. Mansion, mansion robe and a crown and glory. May I know where the sun will always abide forever. Let me see your throne surround. Lord, mansion, roll and crown. My head's bowed and bloody now from the work I've tried to do. But so bright and new. I'll wear a spot so bright, for there'll be no gods for a crown. When I receive my mansion,
mansion, robe,
and crown.
Get on to some of these requests that we had. Any of you song leaders out there, who'd like to lead "O Lord, Our Lord"? All right, I'll lead that one. Thomas's song?
I'll do it.
James? Come unto me, is that what it's
called? It's 932, "O Heart, Bow Down with Sorrow."
"O Heart, Bow Down with Sorrow." Okay, who wants to lead that one? Dad? Every time? Rodney? There's a stirring? Tyler? Blessed be your name? I'll leave that one. The Lord bless you and keep you. Really easy one. You want to lead that one? All right. Confidence. You want to lead confidence? Okay. When you see whichever one you volunteered for pop up there, just stand on up. Okay. This one is in the key of E flat, and it just starts with the ladies. Although it looks like just the sopranos, usually the sopranos and altos sing this first part, and it's we're going down to so. It's three quarter, and we're starting on the upbeat. And this one is a doozy, so let's stand and get as much energy as we can get on this one.
Earth, thy glory.
Please be seated.
Wow.
I don't want to say anything. That was just great. I'm not going to ruin it by talking.
It's what you get when you don't lead your wife's request in the morning. It's doing the same thing. This is in the key of E flat, and the basses and the altos will start on the do. The sopranos will start on mi, and the tenors will go up to so. It is in 4-4, and it starts on the downbeat. Do, mi, Jesus, you were all to me. Why did you die?
C or the do, and the altos on mi, and the sopranos on so. It's in 3/4 time, and it starts on the upbeat.
There's gladness in me.
And the other thing on this is, pull that back up, James. It's this writ right there. I don't know what that actually means, but
retard.
Retard.
I'm not allowed to say that. It, what we've been talking about, that's a note to say slow it down towards the end. And then it's got a bird's eye, so slow it down and hold that last note really long time. So this, although it's an old one and everybody knows it, it's kind of complicated to lead. So just keep that in mind.
Yeah, I've heard that song in a long time. Okay, every time, one F, 4/4 B, and it's a hold, but I don't know.
You're starting on the downbeat.
Okay, yeah. Starting on the downbeat, but that note that's down below. I mean, your grandfather tried to teach me all this
Which
stuff.
Which note are you talking about? Here?
Yeah, down there.
There? Yeah. Okay, so you got a quarter note, which gets one full beat. Then you got an eighth note, which is half a beat. Quarter note with a dot gets a beat and a half.
Okay,
so it's a little confusing in here, but it's four beats. The first note and the last note of that measure each get a full beat. So you should be coming down on every and then down again on neo.
Right. Okay.
Just
saying that, like I said, your grandfather tried to teach me.
On his deathbed, he said, make sure Rodney knows.
Now, why did you put that in?
Every time I kneel to pray, I open up my heart to my Lord.
I open up my heart to my Lord.
Every time I close my eyes, I feel the sweet embrace of my Lord.
This is in key of A, so that'll be the do. The sopranos go down to mi, the altos go down to do, and so do the basses, and the tenors start on so. And it's 4-4, like we talked about, that C means four, that it's in 4-4, and it starts on the third beat. I think that's correct. Okay, yeah. There's a half rest and then blessed be. Okay, so it starts over here. It's up to you if you want to beat that rest. Usually at the beginning of the song, you don't want to do that. You want to just start the song so people jump in. The silence at the beginning of the song is very awkward. So me.
Blessed be your name in a land that is plentiful, where streams of abundance flow. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name when I'm found in the desert place, or I walk through the wilderness. Blessed be your name. Every blessing you pour out,
graves. When the darkness closes in, Lord, still I will say, blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your glorious name.
Blessed be your name when the sun shining down on me, when the world's all as it should be. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name on a road marked with suffering, though there's pain in the offering. Blessed be your name.
Every blessing you pour out, I turn back to praise. When the darkness closes in, Lord, still I will say, blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your glorious name. You give and take away. You give and take away. My heart will choose to say, Lord, blessed be your name. You give and take away. You give and take away. My heart will choose to say, Lord, blessed be your name. You give and take. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your glorious
name. Since I've led a song, so I'm kind of nervous. By the way, there's ways when you're learning to lead at first. The instruction that I got was just act as if you can do it, and eventually you will. Just act as if you're learning to lead. And the last one was my speech instructor said, look at the audience and imagine everybody naked. Because you'll get over your nervousness. I have some handouts for those of you that are directing music like this that would be useful. And ask me for it later. But it defines all those things that you were talking about. Before we start this song, how many of you know this song? Can I see your hands? Oh, wow. Great. There are some, I don't know what it shows on the slide as you go through, but there's some notations in here that are important because the song is intended to be sung. You begin the song pretty fully all the way until you get to the amen at the end. And from that point on, you start quietly. And then you get even quieter as you go all the way to the end for the amen. We're going to sing the sevenfold amen. Question, is that on the slide also? The sevenfold? Oh, fantastic. Wonderful. Would someone please blow a C for me? It is in the key of C, and the basses and the altos start on the C. The tenors on the mi and the lead is the so. I prefer to sing bass on this song, and I always have sung. So after I start the song, you sopranos, would you please take it and follow my lead? You know the song, so just follow my lead. One other thing, several of these things you've been leading, and I don't know why, so many of them do it on the upbeat. And that's very hard to do. Even if you have a seasoned chorus, I'll show you what I do, and I cheat, but it works. And that is, I first of all want you to know, I want a group actually looking at me as I start, because I want you to start on the first note, not the third or fourth note. Here's how I do it with a group. I give you the tempo first. One, two, three, boom. And you start. That is, in this case, it's the fourth beat, isn't it? Okay, so you just watch me. One, two, three, boom, and you go. So I'm gonna give you the pitch. I don't have a pitch mic, so. Let the door be so.
Let the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord lift his countenance upon you and give you peace.
Nobody's worried about that. You're doing great up here.
Yeah.
This one's a little bit difficult with the beat because it starts on a rest and then a half a rest. So I'm not a warrior. You don't start until about halfway through the second beat. So it's a little difficult. What are you going to blow?
I'm going to blow an F.
An F? And then everybody goes up to me. We all start on the same note.
Excuse me?
Yes.
Very good at doing the song too.
Thank you very much.
I'm not a warrior. I'm too afraid to lose. I feel qualified for what you're calling me to do. I'm more familiar with your strength. I got no excuse. Cause broken people are exactly who you use. So give me faith like Daniel in the lion's den. Give me hope like Moses in the wilderness. Give me a heart like David. Lord, be my defense. So I can face my giants with confidence.
You took a shepherd boy and made him a king. So I'm going to trust you and give you everything.
I'll be a conqueror,
cause you are right for me.
I'll be a champion, claiming your victory. So give me faith like Daniel
confidence.
I'm going to sing and shout and shake the walls.
Won't stop until I see him fall.
Gonna stand up, step out when you call.
Jesus, Jesus, I'm gonna sing and shout and shake the walls. Won't stop until I see him fall. Gonna stand up, step out when you call. Jesus, give me faith like Daniel in the lion's den. Give me a hope like Moses in the wilderness. Give me a heart like David, Lord, be my defense.
So I can
face my giants with confidence.
So I can
face my giants with confidence.
Awesome. That is a giant song to face, and you did it.
Who's better, me or my father?
Who's better? You. In case he asked who's better, him or his father, I say Zachariah.
Yeah.
Yes.
Tyler, you're going to do There's a Stirring right after this. been a great weekend. I really appreciate everybody being here, and it's been an encouragement to me. Just want to go back to where we originally started, Hebrews 13:15. Through him, then, let us continually offer up a sacrifice of praise to God. That is the fruit of lips that give thanks to his name. And then Colossians 3:15. Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you were called in one body, and be thankful. Let the word of Christ richly dwell within you, with all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another with psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with thankfulness in your hearts to God. Whatever you do in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks through him to God the Father. We talked a lot about the mechanical parts of singing and the specifics of it, but I don't want to lose the main point of why we're here, why we come together, why we have brothers and sisters in Christ, is to praise God and to edify each other. So if you forget everything that we learned this weekend, give your very best to God in everything, in your singing, in your worship, in your prayer, in your daily life, and edify each other. Those are the most important things we can walk away from this with. If there is anything that you need or any way we can help you, please come forward while we stand and sing.
Before I go, I just want to say thank you to you and James for putting this all together. It's been so educational, and I've learned a lot. Been super encouraged by you three. Thanks for stepping up. All right, let's go. So we're on C, and this is
up and down.
Okay.
There's a stirring deep within me. Could it be my time has come? When I see my gracious Savior face to face when all is done, is that his voice I am hearing? Come away, my precious one. Is he called? Coming now to say
me free.
It's at his voice I am hearing. Come away, my precious one. Is he calling me? Is he calling me?
I will rise up, I'll rise up. Then I'll bow down, bow down, lay my crown, my crown at his precious wounded feet. I will rise up, I'll rise up. Then I'll bow down, bow down, lay my crown, my crown at his precious wounded feet.
There's a stirring deep within me.
Again, thank you all for being here. Somebody cleaned up the handouts this morning, so I'm not sure where they are, but if you didn't get one, let me know and I'll get you one that has a brief overview of some of the things we went over this weekend. And I think that's it. If you have any questions or need anything, please come to me or James or anybody that you know that likes to lead singing. They can probably help you. So if there's nothing else, we'll be led into closing prayer. Let's stop.
Our Heavenly Father, we come to you. Thank you so much, God, for the opportunity to gather together with our brothers and sisters in Christ. Even if we are gained nothing else, God, we have spent time away from the world. We have spent time in the encouraging arms of the saints. And we pray, God, that you would please build us up from this time, from the time that we spent together, the fellowship. And hopefully we are all encouraged and encouraged to open up our voices. And there are some men who are encouraged to become song leaders. And we ask, God, that you would please help us to be bold in every aspect of our lives, in serving you, in proclaiming the truth, in calling out the darkness of this world, in sharing your love and your forgiveness that you have given to us. That in every way, God, we might be pleasing to you, that our lives would be living sacrifices. We pray your blessings on us tonight. Keep us all safe. Return us back to our home congregations, strengthened and uplifted, and that we might go out and do your will every day. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Thank you.